merci de me recevoir aujourd'hui dans Pandora. C'est un petit peu les travaux partout, mais néanmoins, merci de me recevoir. Sure. Ça me fait très plaisir sur le blog de Béziers.com et pour notre blog japonais. Première question, qu'est-ce que c'est Pandora?
Pandora is an online music service that is meant to allow someone to very easily create a radio station that plays just music they like. And it's based on something called the Music Genome Project, which is actually a 7-year-old effort, a huge musical taxonomy. Where we've analyzed songs one at a time, each song along close to 400 musical attributes.
Tu veux dire que ça fait 7 ans que tu prépares ce projet? J'ai l'impression que ce site est tout neuf. Comment ça se fait?
Right, Pandora, the service, is only 8 months old. We launched that in November of last year. But we have been working on the underlying technology, the Music Genome Project, that powers Pandora for almost 7 years now.
Et combien il y a de personnes au début? Quand vous avez commencé l'aventure, vous étiez combien?
There were 3 of us in the very beginning, and we added people over the first year, year and a half. We grew to about 50 people, and then we shrunk pretty substantially over a couple-year period, and now we're at about 80. 85.
Wow, c'est incroyable. Et alors, on a vu les gens à côté qui sont en train d'indexer les chansons, qui fait toute une bibliothèque. Aujourd'hui, combien il y a d'utilisateurs de Pandora?
We have over 3 million. Right, we've grown that pretty much by word of mouth since November.
Et on dirait que c'est 3 millions de comptes ou c'est 3 millions d'utilisateurs vraiment réguliers qui écoutent le radio?
So there are over 3 million registered listeners and a little over 2/3 of those are regular listeners.
Alors aujourd'hui, ton service est uniquement disponible aux États-Unis. Moi, je dois te le dire, je l'écoute en France. J'ai un peu triché, j'ai mis que j'habitais en Californie. J'aimerais savoir pourquoi est-ce que ce service on ne peut le voir qu'aux États-Unis.
So the United States is the only country that has one statutory licensing structure called the Digital Millennium Copyright Act that allows a webcaster like ourselves to play any music that we want based on one centralized license. So we administer our license and pay our royalties through one central agreement to a couple royalty collection agencies. That same arrangement doesn't exist outside the United States.
Tu veux dire qu'on ne verra jamais un Pandora en France ou au Japon ou ailleurs?
Not if we have anything to say about it. So we're working very hard right now on licensing to make Pandora available to countries throughout the EU and Asia. We'd like to make this service global. Not only because we want everybody to be able to use it, but we'd like music from all over the world to be part of it. In fact, I think that Pandora's real potential is going to start sort of being reached when we have music from all over the world.
Et aujourd'hui, j'écoute la radio, sur Internet, sur mon compte Pandora. Et comment toi tu fais pour vivre et pour payer ces gens justement? Comment toi tu te rémunères? Parce que moi je profite de ce service gratuitement.
So our business model is based on advertising. So we're right now working hard to build that part of our business. We're venture financed, so we're not profitable yet. We're backed by some Silicon Valley and some New York investment companies. But we're in the process, as our listenership has been growing, of building our advertising sales team and starting to monetize the service.
Et donc dans le futur, on n'aura vraiment que des publicités, on n'aura pas, par exemple, des comptes premium ou des fonctions supplémentaires. Est-ce que vous pensez à ça également ou pas?
My sense is that the vast majority of listeners want a very simple, free, advertising-supported service. And that really is the basis for our business. In all likelihood, there will be subscription-based versions. I can imagine some premium style Pandora services, but our focus is really on a very straightforward advertising supported free version.
Et tes premiers annonceurs, comment est-ce qu'est-ce qu'ils pensent de ce produit pour promouvoir leur marchandise?
One of the aspects of Pandora that works for advertisers is that it's very interactive. People are constantly looking up a song, giving a song a thumbs up or thumbs down, learning more about an artist, wanting to go back to the station. So listeners do that somewhere between 12 and 15 times per hour. So what that does is allows us to create enough advertising inventory to build a business.
Et justement, les artistes, parlons-en. Est-ce que tu as des retours? Est-ce qu'il y a des artistes qui t'ont dit c'est bien? Et est-ce que d'autres t'ont dit oh là là, c'est, je veux pas être dans cette bibliothèque ou c'est pas bien?
We've had universal support from artists, labels, management companies. Everyone involved in the music business, because it's really doing, it's solving the most fundamental problem, which is how do you find music in this huge sea? So how do we help the independent artist or the latest release from a major label for a brand new band find its audience? So we get music sent to us for free from artists. They're all eager to be a part of it.
Alors j'ai remarqué par exemple dernièrement que tu avais le nouvel album de Madonna qui était dans la bibliothèque. J'étais très surpris parce que je voyais des CD récents et pas récents, et j'ai vu cet album là et je me suis dit waouh, ça veut dire que quand même ils sont très contents de ce que vous faites pour promouvoir la musique.
Yes, almost many of the major labels are providing us with their music, servicing us because they'd like to get their titles into the genome as soon as possible. So.
Donc tu as de très bons rapports avec les maisons disques, c'est l'entente parfaite.
Right, I think that's probably the most sort of tangible way of measuring an endorsement, that labels are sort of eagerly sending us their music.
Est-ce que tu penses que même si c'est pas possible aujourd'hui d'avoir Pandora à travers le monde, est-ce que si quelqu'un avait envie d'ouvrir un Pandora, je sais pas moi, en Europe, mais qu'avec que des chansons européennes ou qu'avec que des chansons françaises, est-ce que c'est quelque chose que tu pourrais envisager ou imaginer par exemple?
Well, it's not really a matter of which songs. The reality of the European and Asian market is that you need to have direct licenses with the content owners. So our objective is to release a service that has a universal collection, but it does require a pretty extensive number of contracts with the record labels.
Alors, je vois que tu es en train de déménager là, vous changez pour des locaux gigantesques. La vraie question, c'est alors, qu'est-ce que ça va être le futur? Quelles sont les futures étapes du développement de Pandora?
Well, there are three main areas that we're focused on in terms of developing the service, beyond just improving the core service itself and making our playlists better and better, which we are constantly working on. One, of course, we've already talked about is making it available internationally. And that means not just making it available for everyone, but also including music from all different cultures. And that's something that particularly excites me to get that going. So,
et tu as un plan pour y arriver?
Absolutely. We're working on it already.
D'accord, tu nous en dis pas plus alors. Bon,
right.
Très bien.
So that's the first focus. The second one is making Pandora mobile. Mm-hmm. So right now you can only listen to Pandora when you're sitting in front of a computer, but we'd like you to be able to take Pandora with you, whether it's a phone or an MP3 device or in a car. And how that will be done is definitely sort of a moving target right now.
Alors, c'est un excellent développement pour moi parce que on a le Zune de Microsoft qui a été présenté il y a très dernièrement. On voit que les tendances des futurs appareils MP3, ça va être d'être Wi-Fi et de permettre de partager de la musique. Est-ce que pour toi, c'est un signe pour Pandora de peut-être qu'on peut devenir la radio qu'on emporte avec soi?
I'm very optimistic about that. I think that the whole sort of ubiquity of broadband connection, whether it's municipal Wi-Fi, WiMAX, these various new modalities, are going to happen faster than people think they are, because so many people stand to gain by having access to, by giving consumers more access to a broadband.
Ça me fait penser à quelque chose. J'ai vu sur le site de Pandora.com dernièrement que vous aviez un partenariat avec une espèce de radio que l'on peut acheter et promener partout chez soi pour écouter Pandora Music. Est-ce que c'est une initiative qui vient de toi ou du constructeur?
Well, it was a joint partnership with Squeezebox from Slim Devices. And that really is a sort of one segment of Pandora listening, which is how to take the radio into your home audio environment. And many, many of our listeners say they want to listen to Pandora not just on their little computer speakers, but on their full audio system. So that's the first of a lot of devices that could use Pandora.
Tu sais que je suis très curieux. Alors, je me demandais, est-ce que tu peux nous dire, par exemple, si tu sais combien d'utilisateurs utilisent justement ce petit appareil pour se promener chez soi? C'était une petite idée?
Well, what I can tell you is, on the Slim Devices units, over half of all of their listening is Pandora.
Ah, ouais.
So they have, on the Slim Devices unit, you have access to an enormous number of internet services, and over half of the listening is Pandora.
Wow.
So as a fraction of our listenership, it's still pretty small, because I think there are maybe 20 or 30,000 Slim Devices squeeze boxes in
d'imaginer
the market.
Qu'il y en ait déjà 10 000 qui
right.
écoutent Pandora,
right.
Ça doit être assez sympa. Et alors, on parle de musique, mais toi-même, tu es musicien. Mm-hmm. Est-ce que c'est un rêve que tu as depuis très longtemps de montrer la musique au monde entier? Est-ce que c'est quelque chose que tu avais en toi depuis très très longtemps, ou est-ce que c'était venu comme ça? Ah bah tiens, je vais partager tout avec tout le monde.
Well, when I launched the company over 7 years ago, I didn't know it would become a radio product. That was a fairly recent development. But setting aside that how we're delivering the service, the vision for the Music Genome Project is really was about helping people find new music. That's sort of my personal religion. And seeing it now spread so widely and seeing it starting to have an impact, so hearing from musicians that are selling a lot more music on iTunes or having more people come to their shows and telling us that it's happened ever since they've been in the genome, that is tremendously satisfying. And you know, that's the musician side of the equation is, you know, wonderful. And then on the listener side, having people write in saying sort of essentially thank you for reminding me how much, you know, I missed music. It's been just, you know, it's hard to put words to that.
Est-ce que ce serait pas sympa justement que les gens achètent cette musique chez toi au lieu d'aller chez iTunes justement le faire? Est-ce que c'est quelque chose auquel vous pensez ou?
We'd like to make commerce as easy as possible, and that's really the right answer for us right now. Whether we do it ourselves, I don't think that's really important. Making it as easy as possible for our listeners, I think, should remain our focus and always will.
Fantastique. Merci beaucoup, Tim, encore, de m'avoir reçu. Vous êtes très, très occupé ici. On suivra de près l'évolution de Pandora et on espère très sincèrement la retrouver dans nos contrées ici ou ailleurs dans le monde. Merci encore et puis bonne chance alors pour la suite.
Thank you very much.
Au revoir, Tim.
Goodbye.